Hi, welcome to Podiatry Practice Mastery. Don Pelto here. I want to talk to you today a little bit about a lecture that I got asked to do. It's on a fungal toenail protocols. Doesn't sound like the most exciting thing this early in the morning, but I want to go over some of the main tips in terms of protocols with nail fungus. What I'll include on the bottom of this podcast is an actual presentation to what I use with my patients. And the most important, I think, aspect is going to be my fungal toenail treatment kind of process chart. And we'll get into that a little bit. And by the way, if you're watching this, I'd like to invite you to go to our next Podiatry Practice Mastery group session or watch some of the interviews. They can be all found on podiatrypracticemastery.com. So the first thing I want to talk about in terms of the protocol is when I introduce this to patients, I have a few slides that I show them on PowerPoint, and they come in with a nail fungus. And so on this slide, you'll see that there are certain pictures of ugly toenails, detached toenails, fungal toenails, and a lot of them look like they have a fungus, and some of them just look dystrophic or injured. And what I always tell my patients is I can't tell if a nail has a fungus or not. Sometimes you think you can, but I've been wrong many times where something might be trauma, or maybe I didn't get a good nail sample, or maybe I've tried the treatment and I just assumed it's a fungus and it wasn't, it was something else. And so the first thing I always do is I take a nail sample, and I have a really smooth process for this. It's really easy. I just use one of the specimen bags. I take a little distal trim from it, try to get a little bit more proximal of all the bad nail, and I send it out to my lab. You can use whatever lab you want, and I tell my patients, I'll get the results in 3 weeks. Now, sometimes patients are in a hurry to get their treatment, okay? And I understand that, but most of these people have had this nail issues for years and years and years, so I don't try to rush into treatment for them. If they've already had a positive fungal culture and they haven't taken any action on that, maybe then I would start the treatment. Then the next thing I talk about is I go over this kind of what the different types of conditions they could have. It could be a fungus. It could be from trauma or that impact from the shoe. It could be from like an ingrown toenail causing it to lift up like a pincer nail. There's a lot of other things that it could be. And then I go over this fungal toenail chart. And once again, I'll put the link here underneath this video. And this chart's very simple. I just kind of put what are the options. Your options are you could do nothing. You could do a topical, you could do an oral, you could do laser, or you could do an avulsion, or you could do some type of a fake toenail on top of it, like Keriflex. And that's what I show. And basically, I just go over and I put some estimated percentages, in my opinion, in my hands, kind of what works. The basic numbers I say are the oral medications, I think, are about 60 to 80% effective. I think the lasers, you know, 50 to 60% effective. It's not as effective. And I'll go over a little bit how I treat that with the laser. And so that's what I go over. And then the patients kind of make that decision. They might not make it right now. So let me explain. So I'll show them this chart. I'll take a nail sample. And then I have my assistant actually call them with the results and kind of go over the options. And they can kind of choose. The patients that want the oral medication, I have a little bit different of a regimen that I use because what I used to do for the oral Lamisil, and sometimes I'll give them Sporanox depending on the nail sample that comes back, but for most of my patients I do terbinafine, and I'll do the typical 90-day dose. I have them come back in 3 months, and then I'll give them another 30 pills, and instead of taking it once a day, I have them take it once a week for another 30 weeks. That gets them out to about 9 months. And then if they come back in and their nails still aren't totally cleared, I'll give them another 90 days once a day. And I just do a LFT. I know some people don't do those. I still do those at the beginning. I don't do them unless there's any alterations afterwards. But I will do this regimen this way because if I had them do 90 days and just pretty much never come back, I found there was a really high chance of recurrence for them. So I don't just do 90 days and let them come back whenever. Another thing that I found that works well is I have them change their shoes. I always use like an anatomic type of a shoe. This can be with Ultras or Topos or Lems or some other type of anatomic shoe. You can see a lot of these shoes on the Correct Toes website. because they really don't understand how the shoe gear does affect their toenails and the thickening of the toenails. So I try to have them change their shoe. I think that's real important, and because it takes the pressure off. And another thing that I'm seeing that's starting to work, I'm not totally sure yet. We're still kind of preliminary, but when I put an Onifix correction system on the toenail, what I find is that lifts up and kind of puts a barrier at the base of the nail. So two things. I think it takes some of the pressure off when people are in their shoes, so it takes the shoe pressure off of it, like it transfers it to the Onifix. And then it also, some people say that it might create a barrier so the fungus can't pass. I think that's kind of hard to do, but I think it's more from the trauma. And so I am seeing nails clearing out or looking better or less dystrophic. But I think the main issue is the shoes can't irritate it as much. So that's another thing that I'm using the Onifix for right now. And then, so basically, my staff will call them. They'll give them the 3 month. I'll make the 3 month appointment, and then I'll see them back. That's kind of my protocol for the oral medication. Now, if a patient doesn't want to do the oral, the only other thing I really think works is the topical. I'm sorry, the laser. I don't really think the topical works very well. We carry one of the formula thingies in our office only because it has a money back guarantee. I really don't think it works that well. Maybe if you have like a superficial white with a portion of the nail. You can do that. That's just my personal opinion. If you guys find that it works, that's great. Or if you have your own drilling system and filing down system and whatever else you want to do to do that, I don't get the good results with the topicals. I occasionally do use one topical, but I use a topical nail gel, like a Cara 42, just a 42% urea nail gel, in order to soften the nail. So people that have really hard nails, they might not get the fungus taken care of, but it's just too hard for them to trim or it's painful. So I might use that Cara nail gel as well. Another thing that I wanted to go over a little bit with my protocol with lasers, we do have two lasers. The first one I have was a thermal laser, which is the Cutera, and now I have the other one, which was the Lunula. So I have two lasers. You might be asking me why I have two lasers. Well, because I didn't think the first laser worked. That's why I got the second, and now I think they both don't work that well. And I think that's the struggle a lot of us have but some patients want it and I'll do it, but I still think 50, 60%, something like that. Maybe you guys have a better protocol. But what I learned from I believe it was Dr. Weiss, he did a lot of the studies for both the Cutera. I think he might have done Lunula too, I'm not sure. But what he recommended is I do both lasers. So I am doing the thermal laser, which is the Cutera, which is very similar to the Remi. I'll do that first, and then I'll do the Lunula after. I know the Lunula, they usually charge 150. So because I do both, I do 200 per foot per time. I do those 6 weeks apart, and I have a 6 week break, and then I'll do another one. I do usually 4 sessions with that. So that's my laser protocol. So 6 weeks apart, 4 sessions, I do both lasers. And I do 200 per foot. It seems to be working a little bit better than when I was just doing the Cutera by itself. And I think it's mainly because I can't thermally get the thing hot enough. I think it does work. It's just kind of painful for them. Then I do recommend, and on my consent, it's written on there they should do something to take care of the shoes, and they can decide how they do that. So it's kind of like a soft sale. We either have the Steri-Shoe in the office, or they can purchase the MycoMist, either one of those. Now, with any of these treatments, I'm also having them take biotin. I have them get some biotin and just to help with the nail growth to grow it out quicker. Occasionally, if there's only one nail that's affected, I will offer them a nail avulsion, so pulling the whole nail off and starting over. I do that occasionally, I don't do it all the time. And then finally, talking a little bit about some of the marketing aspects, I've done a webinar on this, on ingrown and ugly toenails. So I did that in the summer. Basically, it was just an educational webinar. And then also, I can sometimes send that to patients if they have an ugly or an ingrown toenail. Ugly meaning fungus. That's usually what an ugly one is. And I'll send that to them via this program called Patient Education Genius. I don't get paid by these guys, but I just really like their product. It connects with my medical record. And so basically, when I finish the encounter, I can just there's a little thing in my Athena that I use that pulls up Patient Education Genius, all my content's in there, and I can send them one of those webinars if I want, or a little video replay of that presentation that I just done, did on nail fungus. I also give them shoe recommendations for the shoes, and occasionally I have some stuff if they don't want to do anything and they want to try something else from Amazon. I have some Amazon recommendations and a few things, just a few hints. I think that work with treating nail fungus is I ask them, how does this nail fungus affect you? And we sometimes don't realize psychologically how this affects our patients. And in a lot of these patients, it really affects their appearance. It affects their confidence. And so they just tell me. I had one young woman. She came in, and she had nail trauma. She had had previously two matrixectomies, and her nail was just kind of cut on both sides. It was very thin. She was displeased with how it looked. She tried to paint it, but it just looked like one of those, almost like a surfboard or a diving board toenail. And she was very affected by it. And for her, and for some of my patients, I also do, usually in the summertime, I offer them the KeriFlex as well. Basically, this is a nail restoration system. It's basically like almost like a resin you put on the toenail, and you heat it up with a light that hardens it. But she absolutely cried after I did it, and she was super happy. And like those things really make you happy. So you have to really determine how does this nail affect them. If it doesn't affect them at all and they're older, I'm not going to have them do anything. If it really affects them, most people I'm going to try to push to do the oral because I think the oral works better. I haven't had any problems with liver issues, and if there is any LFT elevation, I won't give it to them. And then for those that don't want to do the oral or are scared, then I'll do the laser. I don't have the confidence of doing the topical because it's one of those frustrating things. They come back and they say, "Oh, you have to do it more," or "You weren't being faithful," and you put all the onus on the patients, and they feel really bad. So I think that last question is, how does this affect you, and what would it be like if you had normal toenails? What would you do differently? And so many patients say that they would wear sandals, they would be more confident, it would help them. And that's where, even if you can't clear the fungus, I think doing the something like the KeriFlex can help. Okay, so those are my thoughts on the fungal toenail protocols. Hope this helped. Once again, underneath this podcast, I'm going to put the link to my presentation. And if you guys have any questions, send me a question and go to Podiatry Practice Mastery and join, and we'll get you at the next group session. Okay, thanks.